Hi everyone! I am Christine.
I'm Mildred.
I'm Jessica.
And welcome back to our vlog.
In today's episode,
we are going to feature the different cultural heritage left by Spaniards here in Bohol. We're so lucky because we are being accompanied by my friends, and they are first is Anjali, then second is Angelica, and this is Faith, and this is Angel. Ever beautiful. Hi.
We are going to Punta Cross Watchtower and we're going to ride the Jeepney.
Yay!
Yes! Hi! Our first stop is Punta Cruz Watchtower. So, Punta Cruz Watchtower is located 14 kilometers from the capital of Bohol, which is Tagbilaran City. Punta Cruz Watchtower is an ancient stone watchtower built by the townspeople as a lookout for incoming pirates. So now, let's invade Punta Cruz Watchtower. Come!
Yes.
Where's the other?
Upstairs.
Okay. This is Senior San Vicente Emperor.
So this is what the watchtower looks like inside.
This tower holds a commanding view of the sea facing Cebu, Siquijor, and Mindanao. And this is designated as a tourist spot now. The surrounding area has been developed into a park.
So this is the view. We will not leave this watchtower without taking a picture.
Definitely.
Come.
On a rock cliff just down into the sea, there is a wooden cross.
Continue, Angel. Faster.
Maya, balik. And this cross has saved many people from the pirates and the murderers.
So, this is what the cross like. It is facing the
sea.
And this is the Punta Cruz Watchtower.
So guys, we're going to Baclayan Church right now.
Going inside now.
side eh. So many places kasi here. And
so Baclayon has many ancestral houses that was built during the Spanish era. Yes, here in Bohol. So one of these is from our back. Yes, you can see it, right?
Yes, I can see it.
So I wish we hope that we can interview the owner. So, yes. We're gonna go inside the house. Yes, right now.
Thank you. We're going inside now.
Yes.
So
we are so very lucky because we've got to interview one of the great grandchildren of the owner of the house. Say hi, please.
Hello.
Yeah, he's also the great grandchildren of the owner. So we are going to interview the owner of the house. One of the grandchildren of the owner. So, yes, we are going to. What's your name?
Corazon Ongke.
Ah, Corazon Ongke. Yes, she's the one of the owner of the house.
Malone ancestral house.
So,
siguro dili jud ko sa kanang mga butang siguro ko kira gud siguro tay nga pagtatubog mo mga Domingo kay kanana mo amo ang pagmangkor ba mo ra jud toy nakuha na man guni sa tourism siguro nakuha na ja kasi dili magkapanta dili magkapareha basta go Australia kini mga butang ni sige na kay bawon sige na gika sa among lulo, among mama, kami na. Pero tingali kini bayay gika sa
lulo. So, mga ninuno, kaninuno.
Kay sa among nahibawan, murag na may last twin kasi yung iyaan, inana pa ba? Kay naman ko mga last twin. Tama, Spanish pa ganito.
Spanish ganito?
Spanish pa ganito.
Sa last twin. Buti ko pa rin.
Di ang kwan dili dili Spanish pero siguro sa unang ito minanak pero ato sila mga kwan ito mga biyahe kita yung business. Kani mga buta ni eh paginanaran di ko makapat kay katong pagmangko ana butoy nagkuan mga buta ni manang kami og pagkangala ni mga buta buta ni di mi makta sto ya kay mas jam ko ra kay bawo jud kay mo ra seminar la sa sila si amo ra tagiya kay bawo jud ni sa imo din hima jud bud ko na tao ini jud ko gi ana kana mo na yah mama so na ho na sa matay na mo sila
so dagan ko yung mga dagan ko yung mga ako ang yaring mga tourist
ko ang turista ko na ko yun ay mali din eh nagpatpan mga nini nagpa sana ka na nagdya dito ako.
Ah, pwede siya nga.
Sa una, nag-stay? Pag homestay, nag-homestay may. Siya, pag dagang nga mga estudyante sa Kuan sa Cebu, Makulada. Kahit ka mga February, mas siguro to, pila siya to kayir nga na ay mag-homestay ang mga estudyante. Pero hindi ka natutuloy mo. Huwa namin nag-homestay kay ka na CR. Huwa na po. Delikado na po. Yan ang mga foreigner, mga Korea, naman mag-homestay yun, mga foreigner.
Foreigner kasi ba?
Adi, naman, pwede kasi, ako, kasi na na, dagan ang ganyan mga hit, pero kung palibara na, ba naman yung homestay? Kaya
naman.
Mga education mo?
Yes, ma'am. Projects of your history.
Sige na, mabalik-balik na yung taga-Baiso din eh. Mga tourism, mga kumasa na sa sabi. Package-in ka na ko, man yun ang mga Baiso.
Our next stop is the Blood Compact here in Bohol.
Proud
ko na sa
among simbahan
niya.
Nice kayo.
Ikaw tin taga sa dekatin.
Nagakurili ako dre.
Dina
oy, ang dangon na to ni.
I heard nga, kining simbahan, I heard you. Bitaw, kining simbahan is
devastated by earthquake last 2013
by an earthquake. So, to further,
to know further about Dawis Church, I have my friend, which
our friend,
our friend, which is Dumad nga taga Dawis, and
here she is. So Angelica, can you tell us more what is Dawis Church?
Yes, so Dawis Church is dedicated to Our Lady of Assumption. And the Church of Dawis was originally a visita of Baclayon and became a separate church parish in 1697. So surviving the test of time and nature, Dawis Church stands as testament of Filipino craftsmen in stone and woodworks. It was one of the heavily damaged buildings during the October 13th earthquake. So, yes. So the National Historical Commission of the Philippines restored Our Lady of the Assumption Parish Church in fulfillment of the mandate to restore and preserve historic Filipino heritage and inspire our people to value and take pride of our heritage.
So indeed, Dawis Church is an amazing place.
Yes. Very well said, Mildred.
Okay.
Guys, let's now explore the Dawis Church. Come.
Let's go.
So. Wait for me.
So, now we are here inside the Dawis Church. And to know more about Dawis Church, I have here on certain
person
which is the church guide.
Guide.
Hello po.
So this is what the church looks like inside. So Syrian, right? So here's the altar. And then this is Alex. I say hi, Alex.
Hello.
So Alex will be explaining what is the history of the church. Okay, so Alex.
1800s of what I tell you pong church po namin. Balis taas po natin, ma'am, sir. Bari original po yan. Pangatlo po to sa church na pinakaluma po. Ang una po yung Baclayon Church, Lubok Church, at ito niyo pang ito. Ito po yung pulpito, ma'am. Diyan po yung nagmamaster pari kapag walang kuryente para marinig po ng lahat ng mga tao yung anong sinasabi ng mga yung pari po. Dito naman po tayo. May miracle water po kami dito na napapagaling po. Marami na po siyang napagaling. Marami na po siyang napagaling. Pwede po siyang mainom. At pwede rin po siyang makagaling po ng mga sakit ng mga tao. Yung...
Pwede po tayo. Pwede ba natin puntahan na siguro miracle water?
Ito po, tinest na po ito ng iba-iba pang lugar po. Pero pagkalabas po ng test, wala po siyang lumi. Pwede po siyang mainom. Pero ang pinaka-miracle po talaga dito ay marami na po napagaling. Pero nung unang mga Espanyol po, dyan po yung nagkukuha po ng tubig para uminom, dyan po yung kumukuha po sila para yung may mga gera, dyan po yung gumagaling yung mga taong mga sundalo na babaril, ganyan. Yung may mga, ang patrona po namin dito, ma'am, ay Virgen de la Asuncion, ma'am. May mga inilibing po ditong mga madre at saka pare, pero magkakapatid po sila. Portage po silang lahat. Hali po kayo dito na.
So now, let's follow him.
Po sila, ma'am. This is kinukuha po yung mga labi po nila dahil ito po yung alaala po ng mga tao kung gaano po sila kasi pag na mag ano po silang kasi pag na mag tay tumulong sa church na to para may
tayo. Oh. So this is what they they're all for teach. Yes. For teach. Mm-hmm.
So guys, in our trip, which place did you like the most?
Okay, Angelica? For me, it's the Juan Balon's ancestral house in Tacloyan.
Why? Because the
house was really amazing, and as I entered the house, or as I step on the staircase, I feel goosebumps because of the things that reminded me of the past.
So how about you, Aja?
Same with her too. The Malon ancestral house. It's because the house really there is really amazing, and then I'm glad that the owner of the house have been preserved all the things that made love by their great great grandfather and mothers. And then I feel also nostalgic. It seems like I want to live also in a Spanish era. No, like that.
So yes, how about you, Anjali? What do you like the most?
I like the most the Punta Cruz Watchtower because it overview the sea, then the place is so windy, like that.
Yes. How about you, Faye?
For me, it is the Blood Compact.
Why?
Because the Blood Compact shows us the sign of friendship.
Yes. Okay. How about you, Christine? Christine,
how about you?
I like all the places that we had visited because I was with you.
And
this is one of the memories that I cannot forget, even though I become old.
Old.
Yeah,
so
thank you.
How about you, Jessica?
For me, it's the everything, every place we've been to, I like it because it shows the history of our beloved Bohol. Yes. And of course, kanam we should appreciate history because we're not here. We would not be here if not for the coming of the Spanish in our place. Yes.
Yeah. Okay, Mildred.
For me, I like the most is I joke all faces die. I like the Blood Compact, the Punta Cruz here in Davis Church, Amalon's ancestral house, Baclayon Church, because it exhibits Spanish cultural heritage here in Bohol. And I travel with you, boys. Yes, so that's all. And then,
what?
And then,
what?
Sadly,
we have
all
to end.
Things oh, have yes. an ending.
We gonna rise till we fall. They say we got no future at all. They wanna keep us out, can't hold us down anymore. We gonna rise till we fall. When we hit the bottom, nothing gon' stop us. Climb to the top with you.